the diminished whole tone is my method of jazz improvisation. And the way I came about this is because I basically had a revelation sitting at the piano. And actually, I started thinking about mathematically how this music relates and how to be able to formulate these chords. Because for years, I could play the chords at the piano and accompany singers, but I couldn't really solo. I didn't really know what to play. I mean, I would try using the Dorian mode over a D minor seven chord, or I'd use a Mixolydian mode, but it just sounded really corny. Until one day I was sitting at the piano and I came up with this formula, this musical math, that when you see a dominant seventh chord or 5-7 chord, it lets you know it's the fifth degree of whatever key you're in. So when I realized that when you see a dominant seventh, it lets you know you can play one of two things. You can play a whole tone scale starting on the root, third, flatted fifth, and seventh, or you can play what classical composers call a symmetrical scale or an octatonic scale, because it has eight tones in it. But John Coltrane simplified it by calling it a double diminished, whereby say, for example, in the key of C, you have a G7, that would be G, upper minor third would be B-flat, upper minor third from that would be D-flat, and a minor third up from that would be E. So that's basically a diminished triad. But he also added a half a step higher, that would be A-flat, B, D, and F. So basically, those two diminished triads, he made a scale of it, and it became a diminished scale. So basically, there's only three diminished scales, and there's really only three diminished chords. So when you see a dominant seventh, it lets you know you can play either a diminished scale. So the tritone in the key of C would be F to B. And if we put a G in the bass, it gives us a G7. So if we do that tritone chromatically, like, and the bass and fourths, like, and we do the tritone and the fourths together, we get, so that gives you dominant to dominant harmony. You know, the tritone basically is here, you know. So the tritone chromatic. So if we do the tritone chromatically, and we add the bass note to it, so that gives us dominant to harmony. I mean, that gives us dominant to dominant harmony. And by the same token, if we do that was the fourth to the seventh, now we do the seventh to the fourth, we get the same result, like this. So basically, it's the same chord progression, but it's a different inversion of that very same chord progression. So that's what enables it to work. All right, so the other thing is that once we do that, we can go back to the original tritone, and instead of playing the G in the bass, like a dominant seventh, we do a tritone away from that G, which will give us the D flat, and it gives us our alternate harmony. Okay, then we can do the same, the seventh to the fourth, we get the same result with the alternate on. So basically, those are the tritones, and it basically gives us dominant to dominant harmony. And basically, that's what we want. So whenever we see a dominant seventh chord, we already automatically know that's the fifth degree of whatever key we're in. But when we see a dominant to dominant seventh, that means that we can play over that a whole tone scale, or we can play a whole tone scale, or we can actually play a whole tone scale, we can actually play a diminished scale as well. So we said that the diminished scale would be two diminished triads on top of each other. So if we're starting on a G7, that would be G, B flat, D flat, E. And a half a step above that would be A flat, B, D, F. That would be our diminished scale. So consequently, we'd be able to play, play this through the chord progression. So it just simplifies it so that it lets you know what to play and where to play it. So basically, those are the two fives. So two is a preparation for five, and five is a resolution to one. So that's what I have to write. Two to five. Two, five, one, five, one. But two, five. So over that 2-5, you could play that's your 2-5. So we go down in whole steps like D minor, G7, then C minor, and B flat minor. So that's how the diminished scale actually fits over different instruments, like if you want a solo. So the part of your solo stuff will be, that's a 2-5 starting on the minor third of the two. So that works as a basis in the solos for when you're taking the solo, and it applies to any other instrument, so it applies to the piano the same. So basically that's why, this is such a, it's like the key to know what to play and where to play it in a simplified form so that you know what to play and where to play it. It helps you develop yourself.